me, love me, feel so numb.
What's up, beauties? It's Lindsay. Welcome to day two of Hair Week. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to dye your hair in about 5 minutes with just using hot water and whatever hair color that you want to use. This was actually not the hair color I was hoping to achieve. I was trying a new hair dye and it ended up not being the color I needed, but it still came out pretty cute. So I am going to show you guys how to dye your hair in about 5 minutes with hot water. So the unit I am using today is from Wiggins Hair. I have used them before. You guys saw when I got my very first sew-in, I had hair from Wiggins Hair, but this time I am trying a 613 blonde unit. There are 3 combs in the unit as well as adjustable straps in the back. So before we get started, I am going to do a little trick that I learned from Ashley. I will link her channel in the description box below. She said to use the Got To Be Glued free spray and spray that all over the lace. It kind of works as a coating so that you're not dyeing the lace and you're only dyeing the hair on the wig. So she said you can use this, and there was another method she said you could use. I forgot what it was, but I will link that in the description box below. So we're just doing that all over the lace, and you want to let that dry before you do start dyeing the hair. So for color today, we are using the Arctic Fox semi-permanent hair color. This is in the color Virgin Pink. I got this bowl from Bay. He actually got it for me from the 99-cent store, and I just filled it up with hot water, and then I went ahead and dropped a bunch of droplets. I don't know if I used too much. I don't know if this was the wrong hair color, but it was a lot more neon than I had wanted. I am a little heavy-handed, and I was like really enjoying this art that was being made right here in the water, but I did want more of like a softer pink, and I think I should have got like a rose gold dye or something like that instead of this like bright hot pink Avril Lavigne Hot Topic. That's what this looks like. So you can test the hair in this water. You can test little strands just to see how the color's picking up, and I thought the color was picking up pretty nice, even though, you know, it was a little brighter than what I wanted, but it's cool. So then I just saturated the entire wig in there, and I literally left it in for, I want to say 5 minutes, but it was probably only like 2 minutes, 1 to 2 minutes, and I probably should have only left it in for like a minute. But this whole process took about 5 minutes to do the whole dyeing process. So yeah, I saturated the whole wig in there, and when I took it out, it was Nicki Minaj pink. I didn't like it, to be honest. It wasn't as subtle as I would have liked, and I don't know if it was the hair dye itself being super bright in the first place or that I left it in there too long. I'm not too sure, but wasn't a huge fan. But I did like how it evenly distributed all over the strands of hair. To just be able to soak your hair in water with the dye in there and it evenly distributes, I think that's awesome. This is what the hair looked like after I blow dried it, and it just looked like a big cotton candy swirl to me. The hair looks a little dry here, but it's really not. I think it was just my blow dryer made it look like that, but it's really not that dry. So I had a bright idea. Let's make it a little lavender. I did still have some of this High Voltage Manic Panic purple dye, and then the conditioner that I mixed together. This is what I did when I dyed my hair blonde and then I wanted to tone it. So I used this because I knew it would make more of a lavender shade. So I was like, if I can't go fully pink and I know I can't pull that off, maybe we should try some lavender. But it still wasn't what I it wasn't really what I was going for, but you know what, for the sake of this video, we just kept it going. So I mixed those two together. We got this beautiful purpley blue shade, and I just kind of, you know, put that all over, and I ran out. That was another problem. I literally used all the conditioner. I ran out. Another thing is it was super difficult to try and comb out and comb throughout the hair. So it's like, all right, we're just gonna have to have two-toned hair, which wasn't bad. I don't know why these two colors I thought I could do something with. So kind of came out looking like a unicorn, but it's all about the process and the method. And this method works very well for dyeing hair. I just wasn't a huge fan of the colors, to be honest. It did not dye the lace, which is awesome. So thank you, Ashley, for that little tip. But this water dyeing process is honestly my new favorite thing. I don't think I'm ever gonna pick up a paintbrush to dye hair again. So this is the finished look after I trimmed it and styled it a little bit more. I'm kind of getting like Katy Perry, California Girls vibes meets My Little Pony. That's really what it is. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you don't like this color, I totally get it. I understand. It's probably not my color, but that's what we tried today. So I do hope you guys try this method. Tweet me pictures if you dye a 613 Wig. I will have all of Wiggins Hair's links and info in the description box below, so be sure to check that out. Let me know if you have any questions. And if you're new here, don't forget to press that subscribe button. Thank you guys again for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, y'all.